Hey everybody, it's Lavender Town, and today I'm going to be talking about how to make the perfect portfolio. Because I know a lot of you are really interested in art school and art careers, and the one thing you need to get either of those is to have a portfolio. And I remember when I was building my portfolio, there was a lot of mystery shrouding the whole process, so I wanted to make it a little bit easier for you guys so you don't have to be so anxious when you are applying to art school. I'm also going to show pieces from my original portfolio when I was in art school as well towards the end of the video. This video is sponsored by Wix.com, which is a website where you can make websites for free. And that's very convenient for this video in particular, because in the modern age, when you're making a portfolio, you usually want it to be on a website. I will show you how to actually do that later in the video, but as for now, I'll just say big thank you to Wix and I'll get on with the portfolio advice. So your portfolio should say three things. The first thing you want it to show off is your technical skill. And this is probably the most obvious thing. Everyone, I think, when they're making their portfolio, wants to show that they are a very strong artist who's put in the time and the practice that it takes to be technically skilled at what they do. This actually tends to be something I think a lot of people overemphasize, but even if I feel that way, I think this is something you can't not talk about when you're talking about portfolio. And I'm gonna get into a little bit of how you can best show off your skills. I think that this should be a focus for about 30 to 40% of your portfolio, things that just show off that you are very able and very technically gifted in drawing. The next thing you want your portfolio to show is the things that you are most passionate about. This is the most fun part of putting together a portfolio. Basically, what you need to do is just think about the kind of art that you would do even if no one was ever gonna see it, the stuff that you just wanna do for yourself, and the stuff that you find personal to you. This is the place where you really want to show your voice, and this should be a pretty large part of your portfolio. I would say almost 50%. You just want to put in stuff that's in the style and has the subjects of stuff that you're really into. This is also the most make and break section of your portfolio. It can save even some technical challenges that you might have if you're still bad at certain things. That can be fine as long as the stuff that you're passionate about, if that's really strong, then most schools will look past the things that you still need to learn, because of course it is a school. You don't need to be perfect to get into school, you just need to have potential, and this passion section can show potential. The final section of what your portfolio should really be showing is professionalism, and this part is the most overlooked aspect of making a portfolio, I think. Which is funny, because once I actually got into art school, it was kind of all my teachers could keep talking about. And when we had additional portfolios that we had to turn in later, like to get into our specific programs, it became a number one concern, even beyond other parts like the art inside of the thing. So professionalism is something that's kind of easy to understand outside of making a portfolio. Like, obviously when you meet someone, you want to be dressed professionally, you want to act professionally, but what does professionalism look like when it's just a object, like in your portfolio? How do you convey that? And basically it all comes down to presentation. A lot of the times, presentation can make art look totally different depending on obviously how it's presented, and that's why, like in cooking shows, plating is important. That's why, especially in anything aesthetic, like the frame around a painting matters, and that's where presentation comes in. Now, I was terrible about presenting my work at the start. I was bad at cutting out my work and placing it on mats and making everything look even and beautiful and perfect. I was always just terrible at it, which is why I like to go digital. It's a lot easier, and it's also less heavy to carry around your whole portfolio if it is on a website instead of in physical form. The other good thing about that is that it's less expensive. You don't have to print out all your art on nice paper and then spend all that time cutting it out with X-Acto blades and gluing it and all that nonsense. So if you can put your portfolio online and send your schools and stuff a link to it, that is what I would recommend, because it is, if you do it right, it is the most professional and easy and modern way that you can show your work to a lot of different places without having to worry about mailing it and all of that. Plus, a lot of places won't even let you mail physical copies anymore because they don't want their offices to be filled up with paper. Okay, so the first step, if you want to make a portfolio website or a portfolio of any kind, is you got to collect up the art you want to put in there. So like I said, the first thing you want to think about is the skill drawings. And the best thing to do if you want to show off your skills, especially to classically trained artsy types that are probably going to be looking over all your work, is to put in some classical art studies. I think you guys probably know what I'm talking about, but in case you don't, I've drawn up a few little examples. I've never found an art teacher who doesn't like a bit of fruit nonsense here and there. Just fruit all over the place. Make sure to draw lots of sketchy lines around the fruit. This is one of the art teacher's favorite things. Curtain models are also extremely popular. Basically, any naked person with a random sheet over them is also an extremely common and popular choice and will show your technical skill. Once you put in between 3 and 5 technical skill type drawings, the next thing to think about are your passion drawings. And like I said before, this might be a little hard for me to tell you how to do. Basically, you really need to look deep into your heart and just feel what makes you the most happy when you're drawing, and that's the kind of stuff you want to put in there. Basically anything that you're super proud of and that you think represents your unique style and look of art. So for me, it would be a lot of comics and cartoons and stuff, because that's kind of what I'm all about. But for you, it might be something different. Just make sure it feels true and good for you and that you're super proud of it. Okay, so now I'm going to show you guys how to actually put this all together into a website. So what I did was I went on Wix and I put in my name, and I basically just started looking around from their pre-built templates. I chose this Sarah Lane one because it looked really image focused, and then I just put my name up in there and changed the font to match better with my current branding or whatever. And then I just went into the backgrounds, picked a background that I liked. Basically, you just have to double click on any element you want to change, which is super easy. It pops up with like the whole like chooser thing. And it's quite simple to use, I find. And then I started messing around with the tags up in the top. Obviously this one was made originally for a photographer, so it works really well for illustrators, but I am gonna have to change a few things. I changed the header just by, again, double clicking it, and then this little menu popped up, and basically it would let me change it to all kinds of different things. I decided I was going to go with like a black and pink sort of theme, so I turned the little text bubbly header that I picked out to black, and then I changed the font again of the title to match with the rest of the site. Now this part's important. You want to upload all of the pictures that you gathered together to put in your portfolio. I decided to upload all of the contenders, not just the ones that I knew I was going to use, because then I could look through them in the gallery and decide which ones I was going to stick with. And you move around the order of them by clicking into the gallery and just moving them around in this page right here. And you can also change the layout. So I experimented it with it being in different formats. Like I went into here and clicked on layout and picked mosaic and collage, and those were all very interesting, but I ended up liking the original better. I also tried out having more pictures all together, and I really liked this because it showed off like basically your whole portfolio in a single glance. I also wanted to add some videos because that's a really good way to show a sort of different side of portfolios that have only been able to be added in this digital age when you can make your portfolio onto a website. So I put in my animation reel and an animatic that I had made, which can show off some other skills that I wouldn't be able to show off just in a standard portfolio. I made sure to check through all the other little pages that came preloaded with this thing, because you want to make sure that there's not any leftovers from the original template. You want to make sure the site's entirely your own. I deleted a bunch and only kept the ones that I thought were important. You do want to have a contact page so that if someone sees your portfolio outside of the context of like a school, that they can contact you about your work. And this can make your portfolio site into something that you can also use to get jobs, which is really nice. It also makes it so you don't actually have to put your email out on the internet if you don't want to. An About Me or a Bio section can also give some valuable insight into your personality, so definitely take that part seriously, because you don't know if they're going to look at that or not. They probably will if it's actually available and they're interested in your art, so make sure to remember both passion and professionalism when you are writing it. You want to be an interesting character, but also come off as someone reliable that you would actually be a good student in all of that. And then with that, those are the core elements of what you need to have on a portfolio website. Basically, just try to make it look nice, pick a few colors and stick with them, and make sure that the background isn't too distracting from the art. Of course, the whole website is just there to support your portfolio, so make sure that anything that you put into the website really features the art more than anything else, which is why I didn't pick any of the like really fancy video backgrounds, even though they're really cool, because you really want the main focus to be on, of course, all your work. I hope this helped you guys figure out how to put together your portfolio, from picking the pieces to how to actually get it online and looking professional. And now I'm going to show you what was in my original portfolio when I was going into art school. I actually took my first life drawing class when I was 15 in preparation for art school, and I have to censor it because of YouTube, of course. I put this piece in, which was about a girl who fell in love with technology. I really liked to do these huge braids back then. As you can see here, this was a totally different character who looks basically exactly the same, but I put this one into my portfolio because I really liked the lighting, though now I look back and cringe at that grass brush and that tree that I just like stamped into the background. It's so embarrassing. I'm not sure why I put this piece in. I think I thought the colors were like innovative or interesting. They're pretty bright. I don't know how I feel about it. These are some more original characters I really wanted to show off. I really, really liked using strange masking effects in Psy, and I liked the idea of someone having strawberry hair. And this is actually the last piece I could find from my entrance portfolio. I can find a lot from my VCD portfolio, which I might share with you guys more in the future if you're interested in seeing it, but unfortunately these are actually the only pieces I could recover from my original entrance portfolio. I don't know where they all went. They were on an older laptop, which has since been given to someone else, so I think this might be all I can find, but I hope it's interesting to see how I got into art school and how much my art style changed from before I went into art school to after. I think a lot of people might be surprised that I actually used to draw more technically correct and detailed than I do now. Take from that what you will. But anyway, best of luck to all of you who are going to try and make a portfolio or are still working on it, and I really hope this was helpful, and another big thank you to Wix for sponsoring this video. Bye everybody! Big thank you to my patrons, including Vilka, Lachlan MD, Christy Stewart, Muffins McGee, Paynamel, Cal Pompone, Yaboy ST, Adrian Delport, Joel Turner, Laura Buter, French Fry Bird, Elizabeth Alvin, Riley James, Super Pixel, Angela Taylor, Violet Wilkes, blah 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 blah, Kate Meekins, Addy Visual, and Live Likes to Draw. If you would like to hear your name at the end of one of these videos, or would like to see my YouTube art earlier than the YouTube video comes out, you can become a patron too. Just check out the description box for a link to that. Thank you guys so much for your support.